Hi students, this is the sixth concept from the module 4 wherein which you can see about the history of IoT history of OT by assigning the security. Why I said history of IoT is, in the first module itself we have discussed about the difference between IT and then OT with a brief history, and here just like I'll give a glance about the security, and you could also see the diagram like where the like what we say history of all these disclosures, vulnerability disclosures as per the industry requirement. So just like I'll only stress on just IT and then OT security part only, because we are already addressed this concept in first module. I don't want to go much. So as I mentioned, IT and then OT, operating technology and then information technology. So we know that there are different security issues in the industries, industrial environments. So where the IT related security threats may show the impact on the OT also, like if this IT is affecting, again that there will be impact on the OT security. There may be a number of examples what we have already seen. So what I would like to stress is the technology which is having the advanced tools that can be created, that can be utilized for the industries, also it is prone to hacking. Attacks is much easier because of the technology, advanced technology. So these tools will be available, and it is more obtainable also. So they are more prone to hacking. These kinds of problems where different protocols we used in IoT environments, and many security protocols were known to everyone, and everywhere we could see the hacking experience. Hackers or attackers may focus towards the technical capabilities, and so based on that, like the cyber attacks we were seeing, and frequently we could see the attacks were increasing because of the digitalization. So there is no stop for this hacking, but we can go, or we can concentrate to bring down the effects, interrelated effects of IT and then OT. So based on the security threats, so people are trying to work with more to make the systems efficient and less hacking free, or less problem free. But we know that in the real time there is none of the areas and none of the systems are hacking free. So there are threats in every place. So this is the history of OT. So if the IT is affected by default, the OT will be affecting, because this is an operating technology based on the IT only. So yeah, I guess we can see the figure, the nature of the system where the threats from the outside world will be likely to be occurred, and how gradually it is being increased from 2010 to 2015, it is shown here. So the basic history of IoT is, we know that it is inclusive of IT and then OT. OT security, it is again dependent on the IT related security threats only. So that's all about the brief history of OT security, and let me continue with further. It includes with the various security management tools, applications, and potential risks, etc. So as a part of that, we need to discuss about the legacy of the systems, pervasive legacy of the systems. So let me discuss further components in the next slide. There are different types of challenges, as I mentioned, in OT security: erosion of the network architecture, pervasive legacy systems, insecure operational protocols, Modbus, distributed network protocols. All these were the challenges in OT security. ICCP, inter control center communication protocol, OPC, OLE for process control, and international electrotechnical commission protocols. All these were the challenges in OT security. They are the common challenges. What is this erosion of network architecture, and what is this erosion of network architecture, and all these things we know there are different types of operational protocols, and all these protocols may not be supportive always. So here the erosion of the network architecture, legacy systems, distributed network protocol, like they were interrelated, because the network architecture again shows the effect on the complete working nature of the system. If network architecture is not proper, again the operating procedure of the system may not be proper, and the protocol selection may be not correct, and Modbus. So this kind of things were like, we could see these kind of Modbus in the industries, like utilities and manufacturing environments also we may see this Modbus. It is mostly like what we say, the use protocols in industrial deployments, and its development, which is governed by this Modbus organization only. Modbus depends on the network stack to perform its functions. So like what I can say, to open up with the functions, like it will dependent on the network stack only. So they are the challenges actually about what I mentioned. Network architecture, if it is not proper, then again it may show the impact on the system. And parallelly, the operation may affect because of the protocols. Because the system itself, it is wrong, and it may go with the wrong selection of the protocols, it may be a problem. Is it clear? Because there are different types of protocols, which are supervisory and data acquisition type of protocols. Like we have seen, like SCADA, they suffer from the security issues. So this is about the insecure operational protocols. And Modbus, as I mentioned, they depends on the network stack to perform the functions. So communication or broadcasting, whatever may be. So the content may be not performed within the application. So they are dependent on the network stack only. So next one is a DNP, distributed network protocol. We have seen this protocol as well as SCADA protocols in the previous modules also. They're meant for the serial communication between different types of devices. DNP3, like what we can say, like missing security elements will be handled through this distributed network protocol. So multiple deployment scenarios and all these things, continuously how the system process will take place, and how these protocols will offer the serial communication between these different types of devices. Everything will be addressed through this DNP3 system only. If it is not proper, then the entire system will be affected. Next one is about the Inter Control Center Communication Protocol. It's a common protocol wherein which like it will be used to communicate between the various type of utilities actually. Like it will travel towards the boundaries of different networks, wherein which it will go with what we say, exposure and risk that will give the source of information regarding the cyber attacks. So Inter Control Center Communication Protocol, initial versions are whatever it may be, it shows the boundaries with different networks. So if we have the boundaries, then we may not go for connectivity issues, and if we are having the connectivity also, then there are some of the challenges like we may face. Next one is about the OPC, OLE for process control. So it is also based on the interoperability methodology only, linking and what we say, object linking and data extraction only. Like it is used with IT domain, IT standard. This is an IT standard which can be used as a IT domain with the personal computers. So like to connect with the industrial network, the protocol which we are using, it may have the limited operation. So based on that, I guess many devices in the specific operational function may be affected with the risk. So this is one of the important challenge in IoT. Then the last one is about the OPC. Last part one is about the OPC, OLE for process control, as I was discussing. So this is dependency component, like dependent on the remote procedure call or the protocol, which it will create the different types of classes of exposure, wherein which it causes vulnerabilities with the specific network. So this is also one of the key challenge. And International Electromechanical Commission protocols. So like web services will be allowed, and what we say, there may be different types of interoperability between the vendors and the standardized communication protocols. So through this interoperability, if the protocol communication may not happen means may not happen properly means the complete communication process will get disturbed. So that is one more important thing. So these are the issues with this OT security. Let me move on to the next one. Next one is about the formal risk analysis structures, which is Octave and then FAIR. So formal risk analysis, Octave and FAIR, they are the risk assessment frameworks. So how the risk can be predicted, like in the previous concept I was keep on telling about the challenges of this IT as well as OT. The same manner, next concept we are going with the formal risk analysis structure, which is Octave and FAIR. So operational critical threat and asset and vulnerability, so evaluation, this is Octave. So we know the form of this Octave, and this is mainly meant for specific analysis of the data and specific prediction of the risk. Next, FAIR is meant for factor analysis of information from the open group. So Octave, in the sense, I guess we can see the figure, which is mainly focused on Allegro, which is intended for the lightweight process which has to be implemented. I guess in the figure we can see the established drivers, profile assets, identity threats, identify and then mitigate the risk. So as per this, so this main version is focused, Octave version is focused towards this Allegro, which is intended for the lightweight process and less burden process which can be implemented. So here the security team is not like standby. They'll initiate the comprehensive security review. So based on that, the process may be little appropriate. And the technology, whatever we are seeing, they may be focused on the human assets, like how the humans will think and how the process should take place at a faster rate and everything. Like as per the diagram, like we could see understanding of this attributes, particularly like what we can say, the first, second and third steps. The first step is just like risk management criterion. At any point in the stages, prioritization can take place against this reference model. That is the first step. Establishing the risk management criteria is the first step. And second one, here in the previous step, like prioritization can take place as per the model, and the process will be initiated. And the second step, develop an information asset profile, the profile which is popular with some of the assets or some of the prioritization content attributes will be incorporated here, whereas this profile process will be multiple process will be included with the multiple stages. There are different types of attributes for this prioritization as well. The third step, we need to identify the information with the asset containers, which is included here. Identify the information asset containers. And the range of the transport, in this, like the range of the transport which is possible with the corresponding location will be identified, and the content will be forwarded and the documentation will be taken place as per the record. And the next one is about the identifying the areas of concern. So I said like hard copy of the content will be stored as per the third step. Because of the transportation, as per the possibility of the transportation for the corresponding location, the data might be analyzed and then stored. So the fourth step, we need to identify the area of that particular concern. So wherein which, with that areas of concern, the data flow, touch of the data, attributes of the data, everything will be identified. So as per the perspective of the application case study. So at this stage, again, analysis maybe like identifying the risk, and again what kind of risk analysis is there, everything will be described here. So the next one is about the FAIR. So there are still more steps actually. So five steps we have seen. At sixth step, the risk will be identified, and risk is will be identified, and at this Octave, like we can focus towards this risk analysis where it is localized, and we can extend the boundaries of that specific operation. The seventh step, risk analysis, with the effort of placed in the qualitative evaluation of the risk. So because if we identify the risk, if you are not evaluating properly, if you are not understanding properly, then the process may come back to the first step only. So mitigation has to be applied at the eighth step, and if the process is correct, then the decision can be taken at this particular step and it can be processed further, and the documentation can be done as per the accepting the risk and processing the risk, and we can get the output. So the first mitigation task, as I mentioned, accepting the risk. The second mitigate task is just putting the efforts to control the data processing. So this is what about this Octave formal risk analysis structure. Next one is about the FAIR, factory analysis of information risk. It's as usual, it is a technical standard defined from this open group. So here mainly we focus towards the security concept only. As it is like Octave, they have specific applications with the specific operational technology. That is, Octave is generic, which is focused towards security within the network, and FAIR, and here the FAIR is just specific for the applications within the operational technology. Okay, it will be so clear about which applications it has to run and what is the operating technology. And they mainly focus towards the identification of the risk information based on certain specifications, like what I can say, based on specifications in the sense, for that specific risk in that particular application, what is the operational technology can be used, and what are the attributes for that, and how the risk can be measured. And what kind of factors can be emphasized to define and to process the risk associated with the content. So these things will be identified through the FAIR. So as I mentioned, FAIR and Octave. So these both will be used for the security enhancement only. So this is all about this formal risk analysis part. The next one is about the phased application of security in operational environment. Let me move on to the next slide. Secured network infrastructure and assets. In the phased application security in operational environment, we are discussing only about the secured network infrastructure and the corresponding assets. I guess we could see the slide wherein which it includes with the hierarchical model, how the security can be evolved as a part of different levels of a process. I guess we could see the first step, we need to analyze the basic network design, which is a secure basic network design, and later automated process, even like hierarchical distribution, hierarchical energy distribution will take over, wherein which we can identify with that like network design and the operational design based on this hierarchical energy distribution system, and the process will be discovered, and the process will be discovered with the safety, security, operational state, etc., etc. So here the main condition is discover the network has to discover the process with the manual inspection and with the communication or connections with the aggregation point and all. So to like this process of discovery include with the search of this wireless access points also, because security is a main component here. The process has to be discovered with security and operational states as well. So firewall and then networking technologies or infrastructure data, whatever we are using, all these things like link together, and what we say, link with the devices, and the traffic problems, the traffic path will be what we say, will be diverted if required. The traffic translation will happen here. Network infrastructure also will provide the ability for the security communications based on the different statistics. So here main thing is the primary information, primary method or information will be encrypted here, encrypted with encrypted communications, and through this virtual private network like VPNs, we can go for security part with various forms which may be appropriate or inappropriate. So secure network infrastructure assets, like which includes with emphasizing on more onto the security part, for the analysis part and the basic network design part, automated process, discovery process, and so all these were the important content for the secure network infrastructure and the asset. So this is the last concept which we are ended with this module 4. Thank you.